Hi, this video focuses on shoulder stabilisation. It's just going to be helping you open out your chest and help you to learn how to set the shoulders and engage all the right stabilising muscles that sit around the shoulder girdle. So, we're going to start off with a little bit of shoulder setting from box position. So ladies, if you bring yourself into box position, hands shoulder width apart, knees hip width apart, all we're going to do is allow the shoulder blade to lift away from the spine, and you get this dropping sensation in the centre, and then pull the shoulder blades back around, slide them down the spine. So just give me 5 or 6 reps of those. Allow the shoulder blades to collapse, and then slide the shoulder blades back and down. It's like you're imagining you're sliding your shoulder blades into a pair of back pockets, and we're just trying to really strengthen the muscles that sit around the shoulders. Lovely. So that's exercise 1. Have a go at doing this. Try 12 to 14 reps. So you can do the shoulder setting from kneeling. If you lift the shoulders and then slide the shoulder blades down your spine, squeeze the shoulder blade behind your back. And again, it's that lifting and sliding motion as if you're sliding those shoulder blades into your back pocket. So this is a nice little warm up for those shoulders before we go into some harder exercises. Lovely. Bringing your arms out in front now, palms facing. All we're going to do is take the right arm out to the side, palm facing up towards the ceiling. Squeeze the shoulder blade and then bring the hand back to center. Take the left arm out to the side, palm facing up. Good. Keep going alternate sides. I'd say about 4 to 6 reps on each side. And you're really thinking about engaging behind the shoulders and squeezing the shoulder blade back as you take the hand out to the side. Lovely stuff. Good. So once you've done 4 to 6 reps here, take yourself one of the blocks. And if you're at home, you can use a pillow or a book or anything where you can keep your hands out and shoulder width apart. So you want the block sideways up. Lovely. All you're going to do is squeeze the block as hard as you can with the palms of your hands. Just make sure your shoulders haven't crept up towards your ears. Slide them back and down. And from here, we turn the crease of the elbow up towards the ceiling. This engages the lats and helps the shoulders to sit in the right position. Lovely. So all we're going to do is keep those elbow creases up towards the ceiling, squeeze the block as hard as you can for a count of 10. Lovely. Keep holding, holding, holding. Lovely. Breathing through. And relax. Good stuff. So that's your third exercise. You can pop the block down now, ladies, and then just come down onto your tummy with your arms at right angles either side of the body, okay? Lovely. Good. From here, lift the nose away from the mat, tuck the chin under. Lovely. And all you're going to do is raise the chest away from the mat with the arms. So bring the arms up and then lower. Squeezing that mid-thoracic spine as you lift, keeping the chin tucked under. We're just working from the mid-spine, so it's just the top part of the back that wants to be working. The lower back stays nice and relaxed. Okay? As you lift the upper body away, you're going to be squeezing the shoulder blades behind your back and almost just raising those arms a little higher as you lift. So lift good and lower. If you want to use your out breath to help you on the lift, this can help engage the muscles a little further. Good. Make sure as well you keep your belly button pulled in. Try not to let the belly flop. You want to keep that core engaged throughout the exercise. The lower body is going to stay nice and relaxed on this one. Lovely. So you want about 6 to 8 reps. And relax. Good. From here, extend the arms out in front of you, palms facing. Again, keep the chin tucked in, the neck long. Draw that belly in, push the pubic bone down into the mat to keep the lower back nice and long. All we're going to do here is slide those shoulders back down the spine so that they're not up by the ears. And you're just going to lift and raise alternate arms, trying to keep the torso still. Lovely, so keep that chin tucked in, and it's just the arm that we raise. Lovely. If you want the harder version, you can lift and raise both arms at the same time. Good. Make sure the head is just slightly lifted away from there. Last two. Lovely. And then bring yourself in a cat stretch to finish. So up on all fours, lift the spine up to the ceiling, curling through the spine, tucking the head and the shoulders under. And that concludes the shoulder stabilization exercises. So if you've got any questions or you're unsure about any of the exercises, just leave me a comment in the contact us section or pop me an email. Thank you.